Hello, Jang here from JANGBRiCKS.com with a look at a Toys R Us exclusive Mega Bloks Halo set for mid-year 2014. This one's called the Anniversary Collection Battleground. It comes with 61 pieces. This set is all about the figures, and this is the main one here, Tartarus, from Halo 2, the Brute Chieftain of his era. He is a big, big baddie. And this is the first time that we've gotten him or anything like him. Got the great new head mold there. Looks very, very nice. The shaping, the detailing on the crest on his left shoulder armor is really good. And then the weapon, obviously Gravity Hammer, it's supposed to be the hammer of the Fist of Rukt, which is an older model of Grav Hammer, which looks different than this. This is just the standard Gravity Hammer mold. I actually like the look of this thing. You know, okay, they could have given us an entirely new mold just for this one piece, for this one set, but this thing is so nicely detailed. I'm really proud to have that piece in my collection now. Let's take a look at the figure. You can see a little bit of painting on the arm. Also, it has a different color for the hair going all the way around to try to make it look a little bit more fur-like. These two brutes are officially called miners, which to me doesn't make any sense because those are red captain flags on their backs. Somebody correct me if I'm missing something, but that's just how you recognize, one of the major ways you recognize a Halo 2 brute captain. They've got the big old sail, the big old holographic emblem on the back with not much armor at all on the body. They went back to the older style of heads, which I think is perfect. I think these look just right. They have the right amount of armor. The colors are pretty good. Interesting that they gave us the trance red colors for the identical plasma rifles there, trying to go for the Brute Special Edition plasma rifles, kind of trying to show the glow that those things had, the reddish glow, by going all the way transparent. You know, they could have used the kind of iridescent red color that they've done before, but I think this is a nice little bit of change, and I get it. It definitely makes sense to me. They also got one single spike grenade there in one of them's hand. And then you get these two Marines with the two different skin tones, and these are using the new armor system, the new configurable setup with more articulation than before. You can also remove the vests. You can also remove the shoulder armor pieces. You can see these guys are just identical between the figures except for the color used for the face. And one of them has the assault rifle. The other one's got a rocket launcher. Regardless, they're just gonna get slaughtered. But that's okay, because one of them's gonna drop a rocket launcher, and then I'm gonna pick that up, and then I'm gonna take out all the brutes. Their sacrifice will not have been in vain. So now that you've seen what all these figures look like up close, I want to give my subjective opinions about them. This is gonna ruffle some feathers or some brute fur, I'm sure. I am disappointed in this set. The colors, materials, and finish on Tartarus are just super low in contrast, and they just look unfinished. I mean, it looks like a prototype piece to me almost. If you look at the box, it looks pretty cool there, you know, darker. And I think they did a good job with the lighting there in particular to make his features stand out more. But the real thing is just so light and plain and washed out. Really does not do justice to the molds. Similarly, for the Marines, the molds are great, but the material used for the add-on armor pieces, for the shoulder pads and the main tactical vest, far too little pigment in there. It's just not opaque. You can see light coming into it, and that makes them have a very toyish look. I understand that they may not be able to effectively put a wash onto such small pieces, or it might not work on that particular material, but the lighter colors just don't work well to me with these thin pieces. Unless they're painted, or unless they have just, again, more pigment put into them so that you just don't get that super old school plasticky, almost nylon kind of look. The two captains that they call miners, I think those are really cool, actually. I appreciate the flags, the sails on the back, and just the overall design of them, I think is just fine. So some nice good things in this one, some real letdowns for me. Those are my opinions, and I have a right to them, but you have a right to your opinions as well. Please do share your thoughts about the set on the whole and about the individual figures and the individual components. It's always good to see more different thoughts from more different perspectives. Independent of what you think about the set or its components, if you disliked my video, please hit thumbs down on the video. It will help me out quite a bit. But if you liked it, you can hit thumbs up. That's up to you. Either way, thank you very much for your time and watching it, and I hope that you'll come back for more, because more videos are always on the way. Talk to you again soon.